Fox 5 Health News. Will we get good vaccine news at the end of the week? The FDA advisors meet Friday to discuss emergency authorization of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine.
Joining us now is Dr. Suraj Saggar. He is the chief of infectious diseases at Holy Name Medical Center. He is also the co-host of the popular podcast Recommended Daily Dose. Thanks so much for being with us, Doc.
Good to be here.
Give us your thoughts on this emergency authorization of this J&J.
Yeah, very exciting indeed, Ari. If indeed, as a lot of us expect it to go through on Friday, and then the FDA quickly approves it, it would be a welcome addition. Okay. We know now we have two messenger RNA vaccines, both Pfizer and Moderna. Both are two doses. Now, this is a different type of technology. It's what we call adenovirus or vector-based vaccine. It's only one dose. So not only do we increase the supply if this indeed gets approved, but it makes things more flexible in terms of one dose versus two. And that's very important. And, you know, it's expected to ramp up to 20 million doses by the end of March and 100 million doses by the end of July. So very much needed. You know, we're very relieved to see that the large percentage of the American population is willing and wanting to get the vaccine. Of course, the rollout has not been smooth, and the supply has not been keeping pace with the demand. So having a third option, having an option of only one dose, something that can be given out perhaps more flexible, a schedule, is very much assured. Now, the efficacy is somewhat different than the Moderna and Pfizer vaccine, but the main takeaway here, 100% preventing death, 85% efficacious in preventing severe disease. So good news indeed. We'll wait and see what happens on Friday.
Yeah, all the news on the vaccine front does seem to be encouraging at this point, which is good. All right, another question. Could your eyeglasses add another layer of protection from COVID? This is an interesting study because the statistics were pretty big, saying I think it makes it three times less likely to contract COVID-19 if you wear eyeglasses.
Yeah, we have to take it, of course, in perspective. One small study out of India, only about 300 patients. And what they found, those who wear glasses for 8 hours or longer were three times less likely to acquire COVID. So this suggests what we already knew, that rubbing your eyes, touching your face is in part a major driver of COVID-19 from person to person. That's why myself as a healthcare provider and others, we wear gowns, we wear masks, we wear gloves. And of course, when I'm not wearing my own glasses, I'm wearing goggles as well. Right. What does this mean for the general public? Well, of course, it doesn't mean that we should all wear glasses, but it does just lend credence to continue to do what we've preached from the get-go, which is practice good hand hygiene, don't touch your face, don't rub your eyes, et cetera.
Right, and some people wear those shields.
Right,
I mean, but
you have to wear the mask,
though. It acts as a barrier.
Yeah,
you have to wear a mask, but it's a barrier to your eyes.
It's so it's less
obvious.
Of an airborne thing, I guess,
than rubbing
your eyes and whatnot. Yeah. But nevertheless, if you do wear glasses, at least you can hang your hat on that and say, all right, maybe it's cutting down my wrist. So that's a good thing.
That's right.
All right, very well. Dr. Saggar, we appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.